students, as you can see, today we are going to start a new chapter, that is application of trigonometry. Now, application of trigonometry, and what you got that last, that trigonometric ratios. Actually, from trigonometric ratios, application of trigonometry. Now, basically, what we study in the application of trigonometry. Application, remember, whatever you have studied, you will apply in this chapter. Actually, here we will study that how to measure the height. Now, what is the height? Height of a building, height of a tower, height of a tree, height of a high-raised tower. So, for this, that this chapter is used. And in this chapter, we'll use to calculate the height and the distance between the object and the foot of the tower or foot of the building or length of the rope by using trigonometric ratios. Now, only trigonometric ratios is not that. Also, trigonometric ratios along with specific angle. You got trigonometric ratios, and how many trigonometric ratios? There are 6 trigonometric ratios, and in these 3 are the main, and they are reciprocal is the another 3. So 3 plus 3 is the 6. That is sine. Reciprocal of sine is cosec, or reciprocal of cosec is sine, that is vice versa. The next, cos, reciprocal of cos is sec, and reciprocal of sec is cos, so vice versa, so 2 to 4. And the last one is tan and the cot, and reciprocal of 10 and cot and 10 and vice versa. So these are the main thing we'll use, and also we'll use that what is the value of 10 30 degree, what is the value of 10 60 degree, what is the value of sine 45 degree, those things we'll use here. Now here basically two objective we will find. One objective is the short term objective. What is that short term objective? Short term objective is that by using this you will be able to solve the question given in your book, or that whatever question will be given in your worksheet or the reference book and all. And also by using this you will apply, you will solve the question in exam and you will secure the marks. But what is the long term application? Long term application is that we have seen in the science that how to measure the height of the shadow, how to measure the height of the pole. So here we'll use these for a long-term objective. That is, suppose when a tower will be installed, they have to see that to what distance they will elevate that one. Or when a scientist release a space shuttle, what angle they have to release. Okay? Now, there in this chapter, there are two angles you will find. You have got so many angles in your earlier classes and all. Here, two angles, two very important. One, when you are looking up, upward looking. When, suppose, if this is the tower, if I keep the tower here and if I see this way, this is the way I am looking. And this, if you see that to my side, this is the one, then this is, and this one I am standing along with the base, and this line is a line of sight. And the angle, you can see the angle formed with this line is called angle of elevation. Once again, you see, suppose this is the height of the tower, and I am looking from here, then this is the one, then this angle formed by this end, is the angle of elevation, Clear? So when you are looking up to see an object, suppose a bird is flying, that is the angle of elevation. Now how angle of elevation is formed? See, once again. See, angle of elevation is formed with my side. This is my side. This is my side. If you see, this is my side. Side and the line of sight. This is the line of sight and with the base. So these two lines, this one and this one, is forming the angle of elevation. Now, what is angle of depression? Angle of depression is that, suppose you are standing here and you are looking down. Suppose this is the object and I am looking down. This is also line of sight, but I am looking down. Then this one will be the line of sight. Then how it will form? It will form by, suppose I am holding, this is the object I am looking, and this is the one I am looking, and see, this one is the angle of depression. This will be a virtual line will be drawn along with the base. That means when you are looking an object down, suppose you are standing in the first floor and you are looking an object in the ground floor, there is a line of sight going down. When the line of sight is going down, that one will form that angle of depression. And when you are looking from the ground floor to the top floor, then there is an angle of elevation. But remember one thing, that angle of depression and angle of elevation ultimately is same. How it is same? Because you are drawing a virtual line. You are drawing a virtual line along with this. And this is the line of sight. So this is a transversal. And this virtual line will be parallel to the base. As it is parallel to the base, then you know the condition of a pair of parallel lines and a transversal, that alternate angles are equal. So my dear student, once again, two objectives, one short-term objective and then long-term objective. Long-term objective is that, suppose you are becoming an engineer and all, or you are a scientist, that when you have to launch a space shuttle, that you have to calculate at what angle you have to release it, there this application of trigonometry. To measure the height of the tower, suppose installing a tower, big tower, that is the application of trigonometry. And short-term objective is that, as of now, you are not neither an engineer nor a scientist. Your basic focus is that, how to solve the equation if related to that angle of depression and angle of elevation of the tower. Okay? And then what I told, there are two, that angle of depression, angle of elevation. And both are same. Ultimately, you have to convert and then you have to see. And basically, here one more thing you have to remember. Basically, we are using either tan cot or sine and cos. Basically, sec and coset. Use of sec and cos is very, very less. Most often, you will use that tan theta. Okay? Now, another thing is that, for your information, I want to say that you have to remember the ratio of the sides for the tan, ratio of the side for your cot, ratio of the sides for sine and cos. Okay? Now, let's see. You can see that I have drawn two diagrams. Now one diagram, this is my eyesight. When I am looking towards up, you can see my eyes is half, then this is the angle of elevation. Angle of elevation. And this is the line of sight. Remember one more thing. Here, already in the last step also told that trigonometry relate to right angle triangle. So that means this angle should be 90 degrees, that is right angle. And this another one you can see, as I told, the virtual line. So that is the reason it is the dotted line drawn, this line parallel to this line, and this is the transversal. Then what will happen? That this angle will be equal to this angle. And they, why they are equal? Alternate angles. Then you can see the arrow is downward. So this is angle of depression. Line of sight will be there. Without line of sight, angle of depression and angle of elevation will not form. And here you can see that arrow is upward, arrow is downward. Clear, my dear student? So now let's see how to use this thing in our exercise. In the exercise, that very first question is that you see a circus artist. Circus is a very, very interesting part of our life, where we can see various activities shown by the people or by the animals and all, where we can see amazing other activities. So a circus artist is climbing a beautiful long rope, which is tightly stretched and tied from the top of a vertical pole to the ground. Find the height of the pole if the angle made by the rope with the ground is, ground level is 30 degrees. Diagram already given. Remember, in this chapter, another important thing is the diagram. If I'm not able to draw the diagram properly, will not get a right answer. So diagram is the most important factor. Okay? So let's see. See here, A, B, C, this is 30 degree, exercise 9. Actually, here it is given exercise 9.1, but only one exercise, so 9. So, and 20 meter rope. And what do you have to find? You have to find the height of the pole. You have to find the height of the pole. This is the height of the pole. Now you see, in the last chapter I told that side opposite to the angle is perpendicular. So hypotenuse is there. Hypotenuse is there. And you have to find out this one. So now, which ratio you have to use? I will use this side AC, I will use AB. There is perpendicular and hypotenuse. If I will use perpendicular and hypotenuse, which is the trigonometric ratios? Obviously, sine. So see, here, AB equal to question mark, AC equal to 20 meter, angle C equal to 30 degree. Question number 1. Diagram already given. So then what you have to do? Sine C. Sine angle A C B equal to A C A B by A C. Perpendicular by hypotenuse. So it is 20, AB by 20 equal to sine 30 degree. Then what is that? It will be ultimately AB equal to half into 20. So it will be cancelled, 10 equal to 10. So therefore, height of the tower is, height of the pole is 20 meter. Height of the pole is 20 meter. This is not the answer. You have to write down answer again. Therefore, height of the tower is 20 meter. So this is the answer, solution of question number 1. Now let's see, question number 3. Question number 2 is also almost same. So just you have to draw the diagram, almost same diagram, and you try. Now question number 3. A contractor plans to install two slides for the children to play in a park. Slide you have shown that you have to climb from the back, that is from this side, perpendicular you have to climb, and then you have to slide down. Okay? So, two, for the children below the age of 5 years, she prefers to have a slide whose top is height 1.5 meter, that is the perpendicular height, and is inclined at an angle 30 degrees. Whereas the elder children, she wants to have a steep slide at a height of 3 meter and inclined at an angle of 60 degrees to the ground. What should be the length of the slide in each case? Remember one thing. More the measure of the angle, more will be the height. Less the measure of the angle, less is the height. Okay? So let's see. I hope all of you have written this one. This one is right. Question number 3. Same. One slide. This is 5 years. Another how much is 4? And whereas elder children, that is. That means this is greater than 5 years. Greater. Okay? Here you see it is 30 degrees. It is 1.5. This is 60 degrees. See, this is 3. So see, angle double, height also double. I told already, more the angle, more is the height. So you put 1 by 1. Slide will not be straight as such, little bit slanty. So this is A, B, C, this is P, Q, R. Okay? Two case. You'll get two answers. So what they are asking? They are asking, what should be the length of the slide? That means you have to find out this part. You have to find out this part. See, in the last question, hypotenuse was given. But in this question, vertice is given. And you have to find out the hypotenuse. So here also saying, you have to use sine. So first of all, you please write down AB equal to 1.5. Angle ACB equal to 30 degrees. Here PQ equal to 3 meter. Angle PRQ equal to 60 degrees. And then both sides, here you have to find PR question mark. Here you have to find out is the equation. Okay? These are the things you have to write it down. And then you start. Okay? For first one, suppose for triangle, ABC. What is that? Sine angle ACB equal to AB by AC. Remember, this is the most important part, that side opposite to angle upon side is perpendicular. So sine 30 degree equal to 1.5 by AC. What is that? Half 1.5 by AC implies AC equal to 3. That means in the first case, the length of the side is 3 meter. Length of the side is 3 meter. Let's see the second case. That is for triangle. For triangle PQR. Okay? Sine angle PRS equal to PQ by PR implies sine 60 degree equal to 3 by PR implies root 3 by 2, root 3 by 2 equal to 3 by PR. Then, ultimately what is the answer? Implies PR equal to, if I cross multiply, then it will be 2 root 3. So 2 root 3, root 3 value you know, 1.732. But no need, we can directly write. Okay? So 2 root 3. Therefore, the length of the slide in the second case will be 2 root 3 meter, and the first case will be 3 meter. Clear, my dear student? So please remember one thing, that you have to draw the diagram correctly. Two separate diagram I have drawn. Instead of that, you can draw one diagram also, it is possible. One diagram how? I'll show you. See, this is one, and this is the other. Okay? This is 60 degree. This is 40 degree. These are also possible. Only climbing will be here. Climbing will be here for this, and for here it will be for this part, and for this, this part. Okay, clear? So this diagram also, but I prefer that you draw this diagram, then confusion will not be there, and it will be easy to understand also. Okay, so this is the question number 4, and three. Now last one question I do, I'll draw the diagram, and you have to do the solution, calculate the answer, okay? So, I'll draw, I think we have already copied. So, this is question number 3 gone. Question number 3 gone. Now, first of all, you try to understand the question. What is that question? The angle of elevation of the top of a tower from a foot of the ground, from a point on the ground which is 30 meter away from the foot of the tower is 30 degree. Find the height of the tower. Same as this one only. Height of the tower. Or, same as this one. Or same as question number 1. Same as question number 1. Height of the tower. Question number 4. So, please draw the diagram. Angle of elevation given 30 degree. This is the foot of the tower. This is the foot of the tower. From here you are looking. This is A, this is B. This is C. C is the point of sight. B is the foot of the point. And AB is the height of the tower. And AC is the line of sight. So then, which is 30 meter away from the foot of the tower? 30 meter. So this distance is given now. This distance given 30 meter. And you have to find out this one. So, so long we have used only sign. Now, this is the first time we will use tan. Okay? So, let's see. This one I just will show you. And then I will wind up. Okay? But, you have to do the question number 2, then question number 5 and 6. You try. Otherwise, in my next video, I will give you the answer. Now, here, AB is the AB equal to height of the tower. Angle of elevation is how much? ACB equal to 30 degree. Then, what is the distance? Distance BC equal to 13 meter. So, from and AB is the question mark we have to find out, okay? From triangle ABC, we get 10, 30 degree equal to AB by BC. 10 is the ratio of perpendicular and the base. Okay? So 10, 30 degree, how much? It is 1 by root 3. Equal to how much? AB. And this is 30. So ultimately, AB equal to 30 by root 3. So 10 root 3. So what is the height of the tower? Height of the tower is 10 root 3. Height of the tower is 10 root 3. Clear? So with this, I will wind up for today. But remember, my dear student, this chapter basically will depend on the diagram and the ratio of the sides. That is most important part. And that 30 degree, 40 degree, 30 degree, 45 degree, 60 degree, 90 degree, those measures you have to put in mind. Okay? So, please practice this question. It is not so tough. It is easy. If you practice, you will get a good marks. Okay, with that, I'll wind up for today. Thank you and have a wonderful day ahead.